Direct from the Cobo Center in Detroit, the Auto Channel presents complete press pass coverage of the 2008 North American International Auto Show.
I'm Don Bender with AFS Trinity, and this is the XH150. Gasoline engines and diesel engines have reached the limits of what can be accomplished in reducing fuel consumption. The next step is to displace gasoline with electricity. The XH150 is a plug-in hybrid. What that is a car that uses either gasoline or batteries or both together. The way the XH150 changes the auto industry is that our dependence on oil for transportation is reduced by 80%. The compromise between size, comfort, practicality, and fuel efficiency is eliminated. Development happens in steps. For a long time, there won't be any progress, and then progress happens all at once. So the next step is to displace fuel with electricity. And in order to do that, you have to have range. Most people drive less than 40 miles a day. So what we're proving here right now on this track is a 40-mile all-electric range. So good test?
Great test. 41.9 miles.
41.9 miles. The whole thing worked. The whole system worked.
Yep.
We started in earnest with the physical hardware work in July, and we have a fully functional prototype with great performance in December. So it's been a great program.
I'm Dr. Joseph Rome. I'm a senior fellow at the Center for American Progress, where I run the blog climateprogress.org, and I spent 5 years at the Department of Energy helping to run the Office of Energy Efficiency and Renewable Energy, which does most of the government's clean vehicle research and development.
We just got done with our range test, so we have a little bit left in the battery, which will be sufficient for us driving around and you getting a feel for the vehicle.
Definitely accelerates. Mm-hmm. Oh, that's nice.
Well, I was impressed. It runs like an electric car, and that means that it can really accelerate. It's quiet. It's got very good handling, particularly for all the weight it's carrying. It really moves very well, much better on battery than it does with a gas engine. And obviously, the Ricardo people have done a very good job in sort of making this prototype car or demonstration car, as much like a regular car as you could want. The fundamental problem for any battery, but certainly for lithium-ion batteries, is that they don't like to discharge a lot of power rapidly, which is what you do when you put your foot on the accelerator if you're going up a hill or you're merging into traffic. The question is, do we have to wait for a breakthrough in lithium-ion batteries to solve this problem? I think if this car is able to do what AFS Trinity says, then you potentially solve all the problems without needing a breakthrough in the battery.
What you'll see is the capacitor working. That's very noticeable when you drive the car. You step on the accelerator and you see the capacitor source energy to the drivetrain. When you reach speed, level off, take your foot off the accelerator, then it automatically recharges.
So the purpose of the ultracapacitor is to act as a surge capacity. The ultracapacitor can store and discharge electricity very rapidly. So it can handle all the spikes in power demand and allow the battery to run at a very constant rate of discharge and charge, which is very good for the lifetime of the battery. It's also very good for safety issues. This is, clever engineering using existing technology. You can now basically almost never have to go to a gasoline station. You can charge up at night, so you have the convenience there. The fuel cost at current gasoline and nighttime electricity rates, the fuel bill is like a third or a quarter, and that's very exciting. So the beauty of this car is that it will be incredibly attractive to all those people who are fed up with gasoline stations and oil companies, and that is just about everybody. It's safe to say that there's only three alternative fuels that people seriously look at. They look at ethanol, biofuels, which at least the current generation of ethanol from crops like corn don't have much benefit in terms of greenhouse gas emissions. And then you have electricity and hydrogen. And I wrote a book you know, the hype about hydrogen, which was originally going to be a primer on hydrogen, but as I read the literature and talked to the people, it became clear to me that hydrogen cars are just much, much tougher to design practically and to get a fueling infrastructure for. This car has many advantages over hydrogen car. I think it is very safe to say, by the way, that if you can design a practical and affordable plug-in hybrid car, that you would never build a hydrogen fuel cell car. The goal is to run your car on pollution-free energy. If you want to build a hydrogen fuel cell car, you've got to take that electricity and convert it to hydrogen, which is an expensive process. And then you have to ship the hydrogen, which is an expensive car. And then you have to cram it onto your car. And then you have to buy a fuel cell, which just converts the hydrogen back to electricity. And so you've actually lost like 3/4 of your electricity, which is crazy. So I think it is very safe to say that if AFS Trinity can do what they say they can do in terms of price and performance, then this is the car that people are going to want to buy and actually could speed up the introduction of plug-in hybrids by many years. And plug-in hybrids are probably the car of the future, particularly in a world that is constrained by oil and worried about global warming.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more press pass coverage of the 2008 Detroit Auto Show and all major auto shows, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.